Today, Adobe dropped a new feature into Generative Fill. It's called Generative EXPAND. Let's look at it right now. So right now, this is only working inside of Photoshop Beta. At the end of this tutorial, I'll show you how to get Beta if you don't know. But what we're going to do is we're going to grab the crop tool, and this is where we're going to have the new features. So the first thing you're going to see is down here on the bar, we now have Generative EXPAND. We're going to use it here, and then I'm going to show you some of the other features up the top. So we can choose a ratio. So here's a drone photo, and pretty much most of these are going to be horizontal. Maybe I want to change it to square, and I don't want to crop anything out, so I'm going to choose 1:1 square. Now what I want to do is I want to expand this out. Now I want to do it from the center, so I'm going to hold down the Option key, and as I do that, notice it will expand on all sides. So this new feature cuts out a lot of steps. We don't have to make selections or anything. We can simply just choose Generate to expand this photograph. And if we look, we can see we have three different options under the variations. All of these look great to me. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Now, one of the things you can do is you can pin the position of this bar, and I'm sad to say in this latest update in the beta, they still haven't got this where it remembers it when you restart Photoshop. All right, let's look at some of the other features though. In a minute, we'll have a look at using some prompts, but first let's look at other ways of doing this. So if we choose the crop tool and we look up the top here, this actually works with our existing crop tool and it becomes an option. So we can use default or content aware fill like before. But the nice thing about this is we can set a specific size and resolution for a photo. So say we want to make this a 4x5. So we want to make this a tall image at 300 pixels per inch. So we're going to do width, height, and resolution. Now we can get a specific size. So let's do 4 in for inches by 5 inches. See, we get that shape now. And if you don't put in a resolution, you're just going to get an aspect ratio. So in this case, we want to put it into a specific size and we're using pixels per inch. So this is going to be print resolution at 4 inches by 5 inches. Now we can change the size of this crop. And then whenever we hit enter, this is going to generate it. It's going to fill the area and the final piece is going to be exactly 4 inches by 5 inches. So I'm going to hold down the Alt or the Option key and I'm going to drag this out to get to that size. Now let me zoom out a little bit. If I chose to maybe put a little bit more in the sky, I can drag that down and position the image exactly where I want it. And now I'm going to say, hey, let's fill up the rest of this. Now, all I need to do is making sure we've got Generative EXPAND. We just hit the check mark. And if we hit Control 0 to look at the image, that's interesting. It created a little bit more land there. That's quite nice. We can look at the other variations if we don't want that. And I probably won't do that because this area in Laguna Beach doesn't actually have that. This is one of my drone shots, by the way. But let's check the size of it. Let's choose image, image size. And if we look at this, yes, it's 4 inches by 5 inches at 300 pixels per inch. All right, let's look at expanding something with a prompt. And this one is already being color graded, so it'll be interesting to see if it can keep the color grade. So why don't we go and we're going to grab the crop tool. And this time I'm just going to hit clear. And this is going to enable us to just work with our own size and our own shape. So we have freeform now. So I'm going to go to the very top here. And then under the prompt, I'm going to put mountains. So we can influence the generative fill. And if we look, we now have some options with some mountains in here. I think I like this one the best. Notice it also respects the depth of field. Let's go even further. Let's grab the crop tool again and let's pull this out further here. And this time I'm going to put lake. And look at that, we get a beautiful lake including a reflection. Let's look at some options. I think I like the second option the best. So drop a comment and let me know what you think about this Generative EXPAND. And as I mentioned, this is only in the beta. Check out my other video here, which shows you how to get that beta. If you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.